delivery made is Mickey Livingston. Roy throws 3-2. West swings on it. There's a clean base hit through the hole between first and second and into right field. Peter Webb opens the top of the first inning with a single to right field. And that, incidentally, in the series, is hit number 19 off for Roy. Hit number one off him this afternoon. The batter now hitting at 217 is second baseman Eddie Mayo of Detroit. He hits left-handed and is opening his stance more of late. Pulls that right foot down toward first base. Sort of guards the plate slightly from behind. Roy checks his runner at first, throws to the plate. Mayo swings on it. There's another clean base hit right through the hole into right field.
Stay around hitters, baby. You want hitters, okay? I'm not talking about successful people. I'm talking about crushers. I'm talking about brutes. I'm talking about the different league guys. I'm talking about all-stars. I'm talking about the cats that are super winners over and over and over again. I'm talking about champions. Champions dominate. You got to stay around them, okay? Quit settling for the people that are just around you. Go look for the killers. Go look for those people who find anything below great just unacceptable. Surround yourself with hitters, winners, strivers, the champions, the achievers. Hey, you can't ever hurt yourself going for bigger and better, okay? Be great.
Peter Webb is coming off second base. There's Mickelson's throw into third, but it's not nearly in time. With a hit and run on, Webb moves into third base as Mayo singles behind him into right field. That's hit number two off for Roy.
Never compromise your potential for being satisfied. Look, you're not looking to be satisfied here. Satisfied is a word that will kill you. It's keeping you down, okay? It's shackles. You don't want to be satisfied. Grant, we should all be satisfied, Grant. Why? Look, man, if God was satisfied, he'd have quit with butterflies. Never compromise the potential to create, to be extraordinary, to do something significant and something giant. Don't settle for being satisfied. You want excellent, extraordinary, great. Don't compromise it. Be true to yourself. It's going to keep you motivated if you're never satisfied.
And that's the 20th base hit he's given up here in the 1945 World Series. And Paul Derringer starts hurriedly to get ready down in the Chicago bullpen. So big Paul Derringer starting to throw very rapidly. Runners at first and third for Detroit. No outs. And here is Doc Kramer, who is tied for the number four spot in hitting honors of all the ball players playing in the series. He's hitting at 333, as is Captain Hank Greenberg. But Kramer, hitting left-handed, is up there now. A quick throw to first base. Just keep Mayo close. Cavaretta returns that ball to the mound. Roy is ready. Checks the plate. Throws to the plate. There's a low curve on the outside, Doc Kramer, for ball one. One ball, no strike. This is the top of the first inning, and the Detroit Tigers are threatened. Roy checks the runner at first. Now it's third. Then throws a high curve in there that slips out into short left field. It may fall in for a base hit. It does fall in. Here comes Webb in from third, easily to score. And it's 1-0 Detroit. Pitch and blew it out behind third into left field. And Hughes, the shortstop, went back and he couldn't get it. So the first run comes in, and that's hit number three off for Roy, and I think that's going to be all for Hank. So it's 1-0 in favor of Detroit, and that is the sixth run. Hank Roy has given up.
Look at how things are possible rather than how they're not possible. Rather than talking about what can't be done, how it can't be done, how it can't happen, just flip it and ask yourself this question. Well, how could it be done? Well, it can't be done. Okay, how could it be done? How is it possible? What could we do to make it work? Just flip the whole verbiage. Now, when you start practicing this, and maybe what you'll do in this is take something that you think is impossible. Maybe something, some client you're trying to get. Write about how it's impossible. Now, I want you to flip the whole thing. But how would it be possible? What would I have to do to get in front of them? What would we have to do to get his business? How could we possibly get there and watch the motivation just blow up from your feet, just like roll through your body? Look at how things are possible rather than impossible and make this a habit every day. And then get everybody on your team looking at how things are possible, not impossible.
in the 1945 World Series, and it's definitely an earned run. All six runs he has given up have been earned. And I believe Paul Derringer is going to be called upon right here in the top half of the first inning. Yes, here comes Paul Derringer. But Roy can't get anybody out in the top half of the first inning.
Hey, look to accomplish those things that others say cannot be done. This would be a moment of inspiration. You should listen for the things that people say are impossible, can't be done, it'll never happen. Those people that say, really? What did he just say? Did he just say that can't be done? And then the guy gets all locked into it like a crazy, like a hungry dog on the back of a meat truck. He's like, oh, I got to go find out how to make this happen. See, those people are motivated. They're actually trying to accomplish something that's impossible. Look to accomplish those things others say that cannot be done. Look for those customers that nobody else can sell. Look for those situations or quotas that your manager or the vice president or the president of the company or the people in the media said, that ain't possible, that can't happen, can't happen, okay? Why? Why would you look for those things? Because they're moments and points of inspiration. Make a list of things that others, maybe clients, accounts, quotas, make a list of other things other people said can't be done and put it on your list.
And his last series was in 1940. He was with Cincinnati then and pitched against the self-named Detroit Tigers. And his series record up until now is 2 wins and 4 defeats. Paul's a grand veteran of the game. Kentucky born and bred, and he's out there right now. Pitch for Chicago. The pitch is reset, first of all, to Hank Greenberg. Now here's the position in the top of the first inning. One run has been scored by Detroit. We'll review it for you. Webb singled through the hole between first and second and out into right field on a 3-2 pitch. Eddie Mayo came up then, and with the hit and run flash, Peter Webb was on his way for second. And Eddie Mayo, a left-handed hitter, drilled the ball nicely between first and second and into right to put Webb on his third. Then Doc Kramer came up and hit a fast outside pitch and grouped it into left field for a base hit. And that put Mayo on second and scored Webb from third. So there are no outs here in the top of the first inning. The Tigers lead 1-0. And Greenberg is up at bat. He's had 7 hits in 21 tries here in this World Series. And he's hitting at 333. Small right-hand hitter stands just off the plate. Now Derringer is ready. He'll make his first pitch here in the first inning. Throws, and there's a punt pushed down to first base. Phil Cavaretta picks it up, steps over on the first base line, and tags Greenberg out unassisted as the runners move on. So Greenberg, despite the fact he's a terrific slugger, was set up by Steve O'Neill to sacrifice the boys along, and he successfully did so. Bill Cavaretta taking care of the put-out at first base. So Kramer on the sacrifice moves over to second base, and Eddie Mayo moves down to third. Now here's Roy Cullenbine, who is hitting at 250. And they're going to intentionally walk Cullenbine. Despite the fact that he's only had 5 hits and 20 times up, Cullenbine can be a pretty tough customer. So Charlie Grimm has ordered Derringer to put him on. There's the second ball pitched way wide. There's the third one. And now pitch out number 4. That's the 6th time that Roy Cullenbine has drawn a base on balls here in this World Series. That is the first base on balls issued this afternoon. It's given up by Derringer. Now that the base is loaded, Cullenbine at first, Kramer at second, Mayo at third, and one out. The batter up there is Rudy York. It's a 1-0 ball game in favor of the Detroit Tigers. It's tooth and nail here this afternoon, and it will be for the entire length of this ball game. Derringer winds up slowly, delivers, change of pace, throw it in for a strike. That was a 3/4 overhand curveball, the change of pace variety. Big Rudy York took it. Eddie Mayo leads down off third. Kramer steps off second, and Cullenbine moves off first. Derringer pitches, York takes. It's a low curve under his knees for ball one. One ball, one strike is the count on Rudy York. He's hitting at 208 for his work in the series. He's had 5 hits for 24 official at-bats. We've got a lot of activity down in the Chicago bullpen. Now Derringer pitches, York takes. There's a fast one in for a strike. There goes Shaw, just reared back and swabbed it in. He looks like the Derringer of old that time. He doesn't throw that high, hard one so much anymore. But when he cuts it loose, it's still got plenty of that stuff on it.